How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today I'm going to show you guys how you can use ExpressVPN on a Mac. And the cool thing about ExpressVPN is the insane compatibility with all devices, no matter which device you're using. As you can tell here, it says that it works on all MacBook and iMac models, which most VPNs can't really do at this point because of the, how non-open source and the kind of closed source, rather, infrastructure of an Apple device. All right, so let's get into that. Before we begin, if you guys are interested in ExpressVPN, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below, as well as a full review if you'd like to learn more about ExpressVPN's privacy policy, speed streaming, torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. And keep in mind that while I am on Windows, there are practically no differences between ExpressVPN on Windows or Mac. So you don't really have to worry about anything. And after having spoken with the live chat support of ExpressVPN, they have confirmed that there are no differences between the ExpressVPN versions on Windows and Mac. Now, typically, on most VPNs, you'll see missing features on Mac, whereas Windows will have those features. But thankfully, with ExpressVPN, you're still going to get access to all the servers, all the features, including the kill switch and split tunneling, as well as the protocols. So great to hear. So I'll explain what a kill switch is and split tunneling, because I'm assuming you are new to ExpressVPN. I'll go ahead and explain those in a bit. And of course, when it comes to using ExpressVPN, it's very self-explanatory, as you can tell. You can just simply click this button right here and you are good to go. Now, if I go ahead and check what is my IP address, if I go ahead and check that, let me just wait for the VPN to connect. And the moment it connects, all I need to do is just check my IP address here. Now, as you can tell, it's pretty self-explanatory when it comes to using ExpressVPN. It's made specifically to be as easy to use and understand as possible. So it can be as simple as just clicking the on and off button to turn it on and off, and you are good to go. So now that I'm connected, you can just go to, let's say, whatismyipaddress.com. I'm going to go ahead and refresh that. I was connected to an Italian server earlier, so that's why it's showing Italy. And now I am connected to the United States. It really is as simple as that. Okay, so you're new to a VPN, you want to at least know what ExpressVPN's features do. And we don't have too many features to explain. All you have is the network lock and split tunneling. Now, the kill switch will cut your internet traffic if the VPN disconnects unexpectedly, and this will make sure that you don't run into a situation where your data is leaked because the VPN disconnected unexpectedly and you just didn't really know that the connection was cut from the VPN tunnel. So this will make sure that your internet will just be completely stopped and severed if the VPN disconnects unexpectedly. It's just a safety measure, really. It's very rare that ExpressVPN disconnects on its own unless there are connection problems within the server or your internet connection. Now, split tunneling will allow you to choose which applications are routed through the VPN and which are not. So this can be very useful. Let's say I only want to allow my torrenting client to use the VPN, and I can just do that. Or I want my Steam, for example, to not go through the VPN tunnel while the rest of my connection is using the VPN. So you can just go to your applications here, select the executable, and you are good to go. And it's the same really with your Mac. So you will just hit plus here. And once you click add another app, it will take you to your program files on your Mac, and you'll be able to select the executable. It really is as simple as that. Okay. And with regards to protocols, you can just hit automatic, but for the sake of consistency, I like to use the fastest protocol, which is the lightweight UDP protocol, which is also available on your Mac. So no worries there. So that's pretty much it. Once you know what these features are for, you can go ahead and decide whether or not to use them. And with regards to shortcuts, if you notice here, when I turn on my VPN, a bunch of shortcuts show up here, and these are the shortcuts. So let's say you want Netflix to be your shortcut, and you can just you can really just do that. Turn on the VPN and click these shortcuts. You have browser extensions if you'd like to download these in advance. There's nothing you want to mess with here. You want to keep all of that ticked, except for this if you would like to not share the crash reports. But again, these reports never contain personally identifiable information, so no worries there. And of course, ExpressVPN is backed up by a strict no-logs policy with plenty of evidence to show for it. All the details obviously will be in the description down below. So once you know and understand what ExpressVPN does, head on to locations and pick a server. Now, you have recommended servers here based on your location, but you can just go to all locations and they're all categorized by their by continent. Let's say we're looking for an American server here for Netflix. Hit New York, Seattle, Dallas, Phoenix. Well, let's just go with LA and connect and see what happens. And I'm pretty far from LA, yet the connection is still quite a bit quick considering the distance, as you can tell here. And if you want to make sure that you are indeed connected to the right server, all you need to do is just go to some kind of what is my IP address identifier, just plenty of IP address identifiers. Just look it up on your browser and you can kind of confirm here. So I am connected to Los Angeles, the LA server here. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and turn it off so that I can show you guys the offers here with ExpressVPN. If I go ahead to the order here, of course, if you're interested in this discount, be sure to check the link in the description. But notice that they all have 30-day money-back guarantees. So let's say you don't want to pay $100 upfront and you're not sure about it for the 15 months, again, 12 months and 3 months for free with a description, with a link in the description down below. You can just try a single month and that will be enough really to try ExpressVPN for 30 full days. And if you're not satisfied for whatever reason, head to the bottom right here and you'll find a chat option, live chat, and you can ask them for your refund. It'll be processed within 3 to 4 business days. It really is as simple as that. So again, you'll find links to pricing and discounts in the description down below, as well as a full review if you're interested in learning more about ExpressVPN. Besides that, comment down below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. Thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.